Dude, that was one of the funniest. Oh no, sorry, you gotta do the intro again. Why? Got waved off.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the
fuck? Not nice! There's a giant head!
You hear yourself!
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Thoughts on getting outscored 4-2 and somehow managing to win.
I can't see it. This is too good.
What are you doing?
Hey, what are your thoughts on? Do you think it's a legal play to kick the net off the pegs? If so, why? Do you believe in sportsmanship, you piece of garbage? Then why were you hoping the fourth goal was called off? Listen. Here, let me tell you. Is no one else is around? No one else is around. Okay, it's just us. It's so funny! How many views do you think your video would get if the Leafs had 3 disallowed goals in one game? Oh, dude, forget Ryan Reynolds! I'd buy the Sens! Oh! What the hell was that?! I don't know if that was intentional or not, Isabel, but hell, the Devils. I thought it was really funny, and in case you're wondering, I'm wearing a black jersey today because at funerals, we wear black! Leafs win! Yeah! 2-1! Over the New Jersey Devils ending their 13 game win streak. The only one reaching 14 tonight would be Mitch Marner, his 14 game point streak, the quietest 14 game point streak in league history. Before we go any further, wanna bet? You can do it at Sports Interaction, Canada Sportsbook. Do they have an over-under for disallowed goals? Well, if they did, you could bet before the game, live in play, or on one of their many prop bets made for Canadians by Canadians. Sports Interaction makes it easy to deposit, play, and cash out. Visit sportsinteraction.com/SDPN. That's sportsinteraction.com/SDPN. And I almost made it all the way through it. Ontario only, 19 plus. Please play responsibly. Back to our regularly scheduled program. They had 3 goals! Okay. Any Devils fans, I know this is gonna get clipped. And I know when people are gonna tune in. I know how this is gonna get clipped. And before you do that, and you get all mad at me, I want you to ask yourself this. In a similar vein to the question I was asked, hey, how many views do you think the video would get if the Leafs had 3 disallowed goals? The answer, by the way, is a lot of them. I want you to ask yourself if you would think it was funny if I made that video because that happened to the Leafs. I want you to ask yourself this. Have you ever laughed at my pain? Or Leaf pain in general. Have you ever laughed at another team's misfortune? The answer is 1,000% yes. So please, let me have a guilt-free time. Actually, I'm gonna have one anyway. I didn't make the calls, they did. Bro, I sat back like the rest of you. They reviewed it and I'm like, yeah, I don't know, maybe. Talking about the call on the ice is no goal. The call on the ice doesn't matter. We established that earlier this season. It does not matter. That's what the video review is for. The call on the ice is for when they can't decide, which is almost never. Usually when the call on the ice stands, it's because it's the right one. And if it's not, they look at it and they go, oh yeah, that wasn't the right one. And then it's no goal. And I go, oh, all right, cool. That benefits the team I cheer for. Continue. And then they go to review the second one. And I'm like, I don't know. Do you know? You don't know. We don't know. Look at us two people who don't know. Hey, let's shut up and watch. And then they reviewed it, and they reviewed it, and they reviewed it, and oh, they're coming to center ice. I wonder if they're gonna say the wrong call again. And there's no goal. All right, there's no goal. Oh, and then they score a third time. Well, they're definitely not gonna call it back a third time. Let's watch the replay. Oh my goodness, he definitely kicked it. They're gonna call it back a third time. Let's wait. Oh my gosh, they did!
And I'm sorry, Devils fans, out of all the no goals, that was the least of a goal. I don't care what the puck hit on its way in, he kicked the thing. He kicked. If he was there for Alphonso Davies, Canada would have got a draw. That's mean. Yeah, he had a good game. Canada had a good game. I don't know anything about soccer, but I feel like we all did. For a moment. Canada out-Corsied Belgium. It's just, you know, you gotta stick to the process, right? Where was it going? Dude, this is, mwah. Here's all I wanted. This is all I wanted out of this game. A Leafs win. Of any variety. That's all I wanted, was a Leaf win of any variety. Well, Steve, way to state the obvious. You're a Toronto Maple Leafs fan. Of course you were cheering for the Toronto Maple Leafs to win. No. Because they don't have to win every game. But I really wanted them to win this one. Last year, relatively early in the season, the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Winnipeg Jets go head-to-head in Winnipeg. And guess what? The Winnipeg Jets win, and the game got really nasty. After the game, the Winnipeg Jets release a video of Mark Scheifele saying to the entire Jets locker room, "Is there anything better than beating the Leafs?" To which I said, "What? The Leafs and Jets aren't even in the same division, Mark!" And the next time the Leafs played the Jets, which was a long time after, like months after, every Leaf fan had that marked on their calendar. They said, "I am doing nothing on this night in March. I am watching the Toronto Maple Leafs beat the Jets up and down the ice." And they beat them, and I don't know if the Jets have beaten the Leafs since. But ever since that little clip, I can't help it. There's a little thing, a little switch, a little something that makes me get a little bit more amped for every Jets game. And then, this shows you how wrapped up all of Leafs Twitter was in the trade. By the way, I already made a video on the Connor Timmins trade that's up on this YouTube channel. It's the last video that I uploaded. Go check it out. But also, Canada's debut in the World Cup of Soccer. Those, you know, relatively minor headlines sort of covered up a tantalizing little quote. Ryan Novosinski, New Jersey Devils forward Nathan Bastian on the Maple Leafs. "If there's any team in the league that I'd want to beat, it would probably be these guys. So yeah, 14, as in 14 wins in a row, would be nice." And I saw that and I said, "Really? Is that really how you feel, Nathan?" Okay. Now, I will admit, my hopes were not sky high. The Leafs were playing their first game without Morgan Riley or Jake Muzzin or TJ Brody all at the same time. And they were taking on a team with a 13-game winning streak at home. Not usually a recipe for success. I wouldn't give the Leafs to be the favorites in this game. But I thought, you know, I'm gonna save that receipt. Just gonna keep it right there. Just tuck it in the pocket, save it there for tax time, claim it. And then sure enough, the first goal goes off of who? Oh, it's Nathan Bastian's goal. Oh, 1-0 Devils because of Nathan Bastian. Oh, and they call the thing back. Now, why do they call it back? Devils fans, I'm not going to argue that it's the right call. But I want to make a deal with you. You're not allowed to argue that it's the wrong call. Here's why. No one knows. The second one's even worse, and I'll get to that. Here's as best as I can tell. Bastian skates, and he was not pushed into Matt Murray. His skate interfered with Matt Murray's skate. If Matt Murray wanted to push over, he would have had a really hard time with Nathan Bastian standing there. Also, while he was making contact with the goalie, the puck goes off of Bastian while he's in the blue paint and in. I'm not telling you that's the right call. I'm telling you that's probably why. Elliot Friedman usually tweets out, like, when the NHL War Room releases an explanation for something, but they're gonna be a while. There were three. When they called it back, I thought, "Attaboy, Nathan! Oh, way to help your team out, buddy! Oh! Oh, they're going for 14 straight! Give your boys a hand, eh?" And all the focus is on the Devils' no goals. I do have to briefly mention the two goals that the Leafs scored. Don't worry, Devils fans, then we'll get to the second one and the third one. I only really have two notes on the two Leaf goals. Number one, Nick Robertson is on a line with John Tavares and Mitch Marner, and would you look at that, through the first period, they were the Leafs' best line, at least to my eyes. Remember when we talked about, like, separating Matthews and Marner, like it was life and death? I'm not saying Nylander should always play with Matthews, and I'm not saying Marner should always play with Matthews. I'm saying you have John Tavares, switch it up sometimes, because it leads to amazing things! Why did everyone instantly forget that Mitch Marner is a large reason that John Tavares signed here, and Tavares scored 47 goals with Marner as his winger in his first season as Leaf. As Leaf. That's, I meant to say as Leaf's captain, but he wasn't the first season. It doesn't matter, he had 47 goals. Marner, straight up outworking the way taller, way heavier Dougie Hamilton and another devil who was in there. He was just a grunt in the corners, throwing it in front for John Tavares, who slaps it past and through Vitek Vanacek, 1-0. And how about this? Check out the new guy, the disrespect from NHL.com. Pontus Holmberg doesn't even have a picture yet! Come on! The Leafs had two new look lines tonight. Nick Robertson with Tavares and Marner is the most noteworthy one, but Alex Kerfoot sliding down to the third line with Pontus Holmberg and Kelly Yarncroke. A line that ended up being pretty good because Pontus Holmberg is pretty good, speaking of guys who should probably not come out of the lineup. Kerfoot finds a way to get it to Pontus Holmberg, who is wide open, one-on-one with Vitek Vanacek. Little how's she going? Five hole, first NHL goal! Go and get that puck! Which elder statesman is gonna go? Rasmus Sandin? Boy, they're depleted. Wow. No, not because he's bad, because they were drafted in the same year. And also, Holmberg's a year older. Almost exactly a year older. Their birthdays are 2 days apart. Did you know that? Save that puck forever, Pontus. That kid, I really like his game, man. I don't think he really wows. He's just kind of consistently where he ought to be and working hard and has a decent skill set. And he's just kind of really good. I'm not saying plan the parade. I am, however, saying plan for him to be the third line center for the next little while. And as long as Kyle Dubas is on a day-by-day job assessment, he drafted him in 2018. If I'm not mistaken, Dubas's first draft as general manager. The draft that got the Leafs Rasmus Sandin, got them Sean Durzi as an overager, and that helped get them Jake Muzzin, Semyon Dergachinsev, who's with the Marlies, Mac Hollowell made his NHL debut tonight, Philip Kroll made his NHL debut earlier this season, and Pontus Holmberg in the sixth round. Anyway, that's the Leafs scoring summary for the game. Now, the second goal that was called back was even funnier. Thomas Tatar flying behind the net, takes out Matt Murray, who spins around. There's a wide open net, and he almost makes the paddle stop. And it would have gotten him into Steve's paddle save emporium, but instead, it got into the net. And they challenge it. And thank you to producer Drew, who produces these videos. Dude, do you understand Leafs fan reaction, LFR, is edited and produced by a Colorado Avalanche fan? Well, he remembered a game against the New Jersey Devils in which the Devils got jobbed. It was this play behind the net. Thank you to Duck Duck Gusev for tweeting this out. It's the exact same thing, basically. Devils goalie behind the net, attacking player, clips him, puck goes somewhere else, and then it goes in the back of the net, and it counts. So now you're gonna say, Steve, how is this any different? Can you explain the difference? Can you explain? I can't explain anything. It's the National Hockey League, all right? Devils fans, Leafs fans, Wild fans, Ducks fans, whoever else, Avalanche fans, producer Drew, we all cheer for an incredible sport in this sub-professional league. Do you know anything that's going on? Have you ever seen any consistency in anything, in penalty calls, in goaltender interference reviews, in supplementary discipline, in suspensions? You can read the rule book front to back, and I can read it front to back. It doesn't matter. All that matters is the rule book they got up here, which changes from person to person and night to night. What am I supposed to do about that? I embrace the lulls. I think you should embrace the lulls. That's what I've learned to do. Whenever there's a review, I go, I don't know. And I gotta say, it reduces the stress. And they review it, and I go, gosh, I hope this goes in favor of the team that I cheer for. And it did! And because of the previous one, I laugh! Did I laugh? Oh my goodness, that's two! And then later in the game, guess what? Devils blasted, just blasted, huge kick right through the blue paint, and it goes off of like at least one Leaf skate, maybe even two, and another Devil almost pokes the puck into the net, but they didn't. No, they almost poked the puck into the net. What happened was the puck crossed the line first. Now, again, rule book, throw that out the window, but if I'm not mistaken, you can kick a puck anywhere you want. Like, literally anywhere you want, except into the net. No, you can't do that. That's naughty. But you can kick a puck to a teammate for an assist, as far as I know, and it's cool. So correct me if I'm wrong, and I could be wrong. I'm not even going to be ashamed if I'm wrong. It's the NHL. You think anyone knows what's going on? If this puck was kicked through the crease onto the goal line and it was helped across the blue line by the stick of another devil, it's a goal. But instead, third goal called back! And in case you thought a winning streak bought you anything, drinks and snacks and garbage flying onto the ice like the Persians firing arrows at King Leonidas. Yeah, it's called a distinct kick in motion, T. I'm sorry. I'm just watching the priceless, like, bless whoever the crew was working this game, just the camera panning and the priceless reactions of the fans. Just, I was sitting there imagining each individual one of them paying to be there. If I were a Devils fan, would I be mad? Yes. Would I be mad to have paid to be there? No. Dude, imagine getting to say, yeah, I was there when we threw all the garbage. I was there to see three Devils goals get called back. Dude, I'm friends with Tic Tac Tomar. That dude was at the Nashville 9-2 game where the Leafs lost by 7 goals. He still talks about it. That happened 8 years ago. Now, after all this, after they clean everything up, they do get one. And the Devils ran the Leafs show for the rest of the game. And the clock winds down 3-2-1. The Leafs hold on for the funniest win they've had in years. I'm not gonna do questions because I already did those, but Leaf fans, we can't laugh too hard. Sheldon Keefe says, Jordy Ben has an upper body injury and doesn't know the extent of it yet. An update likely tomorrow. Dude! Well, the Leafs' next games are back-to-back with travel. Minnesota and Pittsburgh. Friday, Saturday. So that's super dope. Bet Victor Mete will be there and whoever else is able to stand. It's a shame. Like, Matt Murray was great in this game. Mark Giordano and Timothy Liljegren and Rasmus Sandin, like, in relief. What a collective effort by this team that's so shorthanded on the back end. But all I can do is laugh. So that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Be nice in the comments. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. I'm trying to get to 200,000. Tell all your friends that LFR is available in podcast form in all the podcast places. And check out the Connor Timmins trade video that I uploaded to this channel earlier today.